welcome everybody to this special meeting of Cabinet. Thank you very much for your attendance. Just deal with preliminary item first of all. Item one is members' code of conduct, declarations of interest. Do any members of the Cabinet wish to declare any interest? Stuart.
Thanks, Bill. I'd like to declare a prejudicial interest on the main agenda item by virtue of the director of interest.
You're good with this. Okay, thank you. Any other Cabinet members wish to declare any interest, please say now. No? Okay, so obviously we've just got one item on our agenda, which is item two, core strategy local plan review of development options. I'm going to ask Councillor George Davies, the relevant Cabinet member, to introduce this item and then take any additional contributions after that. So, George, over to you.
Thanks, Bill. This report outlines the process we will be following to develop and deliver our local plan. The local plan gives direction and certainty about the future development of the borough, and if done properly, can protect open spaces, safeguard the character of our towns and villages, and encourage urban and brownfield development. The local plan has to meet a housing target set by central government as part of their national housing strategy and the national planning policy framework. The government has established a target of 800 new homes in Wirral every year for 15 years, a total of 12,000 new houses by 2035. Our local plan has to identify sufficient, suitable, available and deliverable land and sites to enable this target to be met. We have argued with government ministers and they have acknowledged Wirral does not have enough brownfield sites to meet this target. But they are unmoved, so we will have to review our agreement. Government targets do not take into consideration reality of our environment. We are a peninsula, bordered on three sides by water, and with 46% of our land designated green belt. Government targets don't recognise the housing needs we have in the middle. More homes for an aging population, more adapted homes to allow residents to remain independent longer, more affordable homes for younger people and couples, and new homes in the communities where people have lived all their lives and wish to remain near their friends and families. Top-down targets don't work. We have been clear we will explore every brownfield option first. Last week, we revealed a list of brownfield sites. We think we can accommodate nearly 3,000 new homes across the lifetime of the plan. I have written to landowners and developers with existing planning permissions, urging them to start where. And yesterday, I wrote to Peel Group, owners of Wirral Waters, seeking an explanation as to why they have permissions to build 13,500 homes, but so far have built zero. I told them my colleagues and local residents felt betrayed. Their inactivity on what is the UK's largest planning-approved brownfield site is directly linked to the need for us to consult on releasing some of our green belt. I was grateful for Andrew Legal MP and Alison McGovern MP timely contributions to this debate, urging Peel to build or hand back the land. Wirral residents must have their say. This report details the opportunities residents and businesses have to make their opinions known. These comments will be a formal part of the local plan process. I commend this report to Cabinet and urge Wirral local residents to have their say on shaping Wirral's future.
Okay, thanks, George. Right, so I invite additional contributions from Cabinet members. Angie.
I checked off this report and would echo the concerns raised by George about forcing top-down targets. of Wirral like Wirral. It's for Wirral to decide what its housing needs are and how to meet them. Next week, Wirral Growth Company, the council's joint venture with Muse Developments, will share their exciting outline ideas to regenerate Birkenhead town centre. And these are going to include plans to build new homes in our town centre. Wirral Growth Company will play its part in helping develop the homes that Wirral residents need, and it's a shame that a private enterprise, the size of Peel, doesn't demonstrate the same commitment.
Okay, thanks. Thank you, Angie. Anybody else? Janette.
Thanks, Bill. Thanks, George. I just wanted to also just talk about Peel here. I mean, I agree with Angie totally. You know, Wirral are in a better position to determine their housing targets than central government. But what's exacerbated the situation and what forced us to build on rebuilds is the fact that Peel won't pull their thing out and do what they said we were going to. I think it's an absolute disgrace. I really do.
Thanks,
Chair.
Bernie.
Okay, I also want to offer my support to this report. And we are where we are in a situation where we've been forced to do this, and I hope the public realise that. But I also want to urge Peel to start building the homes that they've said they're going to build. You know, it's not just for social and economic reasons, but the people of the world need this. The whole of the world needs this to go forward. Peel were very aggressive when they first approached us for planning permission, and they come into us for planning permission for 13,500 homes. They need to put their money now where their mouth is. You know, they could be providing hundreds of people on the road with jobs. You know, when we first built Wirral Met, people there doing this, young people there trained to go into this industry. So we've been very proactive in making sure that we've got a trained workforce of people who can go into construction. They also promised things like shops, and they promised us businesses and all sorts of new developments out there that would also offer training and jobs to the people of Wallasey and the people of Birkenhead, which are very two really badly deprived areas. So I think Peel has got to now get stuck in and help us with this. If they do what they're supposed to do, it will protect some of the rebuilds. So we have to urge them to get the thing around to start building. Thank you.
Okay, Paul.
Thanks, Phil. It's quite relevant that today Shelter have released research that shows 55% of the homeless families who are homeless are actually in work. We do have a problem right across the country with housing. And whatever comes from this local plan, we need more social housing and affordable housing to meet the needs of the residents of Wirral while protecting as much of our green belt as possible. Peel Holdens need to step up to the plate and do their part. They have promised to develop the land that they have grown, and they have been all talk and no action. They need to stop developing their website and their social media presence and start developing the land and provide the housing that we need. They have written to, I assume, all members of the council over the weekend to give their update. And within that update, they have offered to meet us privately to give us a private update. I believe that we should be refusing any kind of private update. Any update that they want to give us should be in public. They should be answerable to the public. They are land bankers, the biggest plots of land in Wirral, and they are expanding their portfolio and creating portfolio based on the strength of the land value here, elsewhere. We need them to invest here. We need them to step up to the plate and do their part.
Okay, anybody else? Right, okay. If I could just say a few words to sort of round off the comments before we go to the vote on the recommendations. So, clearly, this document is a really important document about completing our local plan. As George has said, we have a legal obligation to do that, and we will meet that legal obligation within the timescale that we set out So that's a, I think, an important message from this meeting. We're determined to do that. However, you know, this is going to be a very challenging task, partly because, as George and others have said, because of the kind of top-down targets we've been given for housing from central government, which doesn't give us any ability to reflect local rural conditions. And I don't believe a civil servant in Whittingham can understand the housing market as well as people who live in Wirral. This is not the same. Stating the blind, Wirral is not the same as London or the South East. You know, the housing market and the housing challenges all of you, as you outlined, are very different. But we have this target that we have to meet 12,000 new homes over the next 15 years. And the reality is, on all of the projections that you see, as has been said, we do not have, and this is not just us saying this is kind of government saying this, we do not have sufficient brownfield sites. We will always go for a brownfield first policy, because that is just makes sense. Because, you know, I've said this on many occasions, the Green Belt is Wirral's jewel in the crown. We need to protect it as far as we can, and development must always be our last resort. Be very clear about that. However, we do face a situation where we simply do not have enough brownfield sites, and I think my colleagues are absolutely right to focus on the owners of land, the brownfield sites, who've got existing land pensions. And Peel are obviously the biggest owners of brownfield land. And I think our plea this morning is, Peel, please start developing. Because the more houses Peel develop on that huge 500 acres of land that they own, the more that takes the pressure off the precious Green Belt. So I think we're all disappointed that the original commitments of 13,500 that Peel gave us when they first took over the land, you know, is seems to be not being able to be met. That's very unfortunate, because if they delivered that target, that would basically solve our problem almost overnight. And it's I think very, very regrettable that we're now looking at something the figure I've seen is 2,700. Now, I know there are a few figures that have come out, but that's the figure that I've seen. So I actually think this is a national issue, because unfortunately there are very few legal sort of levers that the council have to force private developers to develop. I think this is something that Parliament needs to take up, because it cannot be right. I'm not just talking about Peel now, I'm talking about any private developer, private owner of land. It can't be right that they can just sit on land for years and years and years and not develop. There must be, I think, there must be powers that only Parliament can award for areas to be able to require landowners to develop if they haven't done anything after a certain period of time. Otherwise, this land banking, which I know goes on across the country, it will continue to be one of the main, perhaps the main barrier to development across the country. So I know our MPs have taken this up, and I'd particularly like to put on record my thanks to Alison McGovern and Angie Regal, who are now taking up this court in Parliament, and any support that we can give them on that front is absolutely right. But I think our message this morning is we do need to have our owners of brownfield sites getting a move on urgently. And George has mentioned that he's written to all the owners of brownfield sites with existing planning and urged them to start building now. And I think we just need to add that plea to our comments this morning. Back to the local plan. So we are launching the process this morning of consulting on the local plan. I would urge all members of the public and everybody, all stakeholders, to engage in the consultation. There is a website which we've set up, which is wirral.gov.uk/local-plan, which I would urge anybody who wishes to contribute to use. Residents can also submit their views in writing via the email address localplan@wirral.gov.uk. There'll be a formal stage to this consultation starting in September. There'll be public meetings across the borough where people can come along and make representations. So we need to, as Paul said, I think it is important that this consultation is open and transparent. Everybody has the opportunity to have their say before we bring a further report back to Cabinet in December, when we look at the results of the consultation and make some recommendations for moving forward. So I think that those are the main points I wanted to make. It is going to be a very challenging process, but one that legally we have to complete. I think the administration is absolutely determined that we will meet our legal obligations, notwithstanding all the challenges that we've mentioned. So I think I now need to direct you to page 3 of the report and the recommendations of George's move. So George, you've moved those recommendations. Is that seconded? Yeah. Seconded by Bernie. Can I see all those in favour? Okay, that's carried. Not aware there's any other business? No? Okay, that concludes the cabinet meeting. Can I thank you for your attendance? Thank you.